Hey everyone, my name is Mr. Drillicious, but today I've asked a very good and close friend of mine to take over and to take care of this video for you. So without further ado, I'd like to call my buddy Brooklyn to the stage. Brooklyn, the floor is yours. Thank you, Mr. Drillicious. Yes, and as you said, I'm going to be taking over with this particular video because as of today, September 9, 2020, the anime's closed beta is out and the lucky people who have applied for the beta and got a key can now play around with this tool, which is eventually going to replace PhaseRank. Now, I myself have gotten around to play with it, and in this video, I want to give a few preliminary conclusions on this new tool, things that it can and cannot do, and shed some light on the one thing that I feel was the most talked about point after the initial announcement of anime's subscriptions. So, without further ado, let's take it away. So for those of you who haven't heard yet, Animaze was announced earlier this month as the successor of the popular tool PhaseRank. In the announcement, the team also said that the tool was built from the ground up and it was eventually going to replace PhaseRank. This means that current users of PhaseRank will still be able to use and utilize the tool going forward, but it won't get any new updates and it won't be available for purchase anymore. With the beta out now for those who signed up for it, I thought it was a good idea to look at the features of this new app to see if it is indeed better compared to PhaseRank. Also, seeing as Animaze will be a freemium tool, we'll dive deeper into the pricing and what features you can and cannot expect when you don't pay. First of all, let's have a look at the overall tracking of Animaze. Is it actually better compared to PhaseRank? Well, I can be short on this, yes it is better. Immediately when you boot up Animaze, which in itself is a lot quicker too, the face tracking kicks in. Compared to PhaseRank, tracking is a lot smoother and more reliable. I really had to move my head a lot further to one side in order for the tool to lose track of me. Also, the facial features looked a lot smoother. With PhaseRank, I sometimes struggled as someone who's wearing glasses to have my eyes tracked as well. In fact, I turned on auto blink just because of this. But anime seems to be able to deal a lot better with glasses. Blinking or looking surprised all worked a lot better compared to PhaseRank. The program itself is very minimal and cleanly set up. With PhaseRank, even in the default UI mode, you had a ton of buttons, but in Animaze, they brought it back to only 8 big buttons on screen. By default, these buttons are centered over the avatar, but you can move them freely to wherever you want. You got your buttons to record, take a screenshot and broadcast. And below that, you have buttons to change your avatar, add props, change the background and use animation. Some avatars come with built-in animations that you can use by setting a hotkey. Animations vary from a simple wave to an actual dance. Not all avatars have all animations though. The last button is for the shop, but we'll get to that part later. Now, PhaseRank offered a ton of customization features for your avatar, so you could customize the way all facial features moved. In Animaze, all these sliders have been removed. I'm not sure why, but it might be that the new tracking system is so impressive that they don't need this level of customization anymore. Something you can customize is your avatar. You can still add various props to them, but newer in Animaze is the ability to customize your avatar with new colors, change head size and more. Even when you don't use a custom built avatar, this does allow for a lot of creative freedom. Even though PhaseRank worked very well, some people noticed that it could be quite resource heavy on your system. Especially when streaming, the tool could take up quite a few resources. On a first glance, Animaze seems to be a lot less heavy on resources. I tried it in a clean OBS scene with only an Animaze or a PhaseRank virtual cam active. When PhaseRank was active, we saw CPU usage of over 2%. However, with Animaze, it managed to stay below 1% most of the time. While this in itself may not seem like a significant difference, added on the extra load of streaming and encoding, it can just make a difference between dropping a few frames or not. And then we get on to the topic that I feel most people want to know about, the subscription model. At the announcement of Animaze, there was already quite a bit of talk and speculation what this would mean for the app. With the beta, we got a first look at pricing. Now obviously, with more people using the beta, it might be that the team behind Animaze will change these prices based on feedback, but this is where things are now. Now most avatars in the app are free to use, but if you want to unlock certain avatars, you need to buy them with coins. Now coins in turn you can buy in packs, starting at 1000 coins which will cost you $4.99, and the most expensive pack that is 6000 coins you can get for $19.99. If however you want to use your own avatar, you should be able to import it into Animaze. Currently you need to make a few changes to the file structure, so I wasn't able to import myself into Animaze, but here's a little catch. Importing an avatar without having an active subscription sets you back 99 cents, or well, let's just say it $1. This goes per import. So if you have multiple avatars that you use and want to import, you pay this price for each single one of them. Now on to the subscriptions. NMAs in itself is free to use, but it comes with some heavy limitations. The free version only allows for sessions lasting a maximum of 45 minutes. After that, you'll have to restart a session. Also, the virtual webcam has a watermark on it, which you could technically get rid of by cropping the avatar window in OBS, but still, it's of course not convenient. If you want to get rid of these limitations, you're going to need the basic membership, which costs you $3.99 a month, or $19.99 a year. This gets rid of the watermark, the broadcast session limitation, and you can import an unlimited amount of avatars to the tool. You can't, however, use it to stream in 60 FPS. For that, you're going to want the VIP package, which will set you back $9.99 a month, or $99.99 a year. You're also going to need this last package if you are a pro streamer, air quotes included. What does this mean? Well, according to Animaze, if you stream on Twitch, you are a Twitch affiliate and have over 800 subscribers a month. Here's the requirement for all the other platforms that they have listed. Personally, I don't mind paying for apps, but I find the prices for these subscriptions somewhat on the higher side. Especially for streamers who don't make a lot or even any income with their platform yet, it can be a really big turnoff to pay this amount of money for a tool. The $3.99 plan would suffice for most people, but is lacking 60 FPS support, which I feel in this day and age is pretty standard. Now, in the end, of course, it is up to you if you feel Animaze warrants a subscription, but this is where the prices stand as of today. Now, seeing as this is only a beta and things can still change, I feel it's hard to give a solid conclusion just yet. Animaze looks to be a good successor to Phasrig. Especially the tracking definitely looks a lot better. The lack of features from Phasrig is made up with the fact that things just work a lot better out of the box. So therefore you don't need to customize them at all. Customization of avatars, however, is a very nice addition and will definitely make that you won't see a lot of the same default avatars overall. However, the freemium model is something that a lot of people will probably dislike. The steep pricing to get all the features might throw people off and might make them stick with Phasrig. Import costs and broadcast limits will probably make that people who won't be able to afford a basic subscription stick to Phasrig. As mentioned before, if you like to use Phasrig, I recommend you getting it on Steam right now, as it will be removed from the store as Animaze launches. Now that's it for the preview of the Animaze beta. If you have any questions or you just like to hang out with this good looking wolf a bit more, you can catch me or Mr. Drillicious himself on Twitch every Monday, Tuesday and Friday. Or if you want, you can find Mr. Drillicious on Twitter or Discord. Both of those links are in the description down below. And there you are also able to ask any more questions that you have about Animaze. For now, thank you for watching. This was Brooklyn reporting live for Mr. Drillicious. See you next time.